WordPress and AMP Stories. So, for something about myself. So, my name is Pratik Ghela, and I'm the director at Prince of Holdings Hong Kong Limited. I started coding in 2008, and since then I've now looked back. 4 years I was working on Joomla, another CMS. At that time I thought that WordPress is a blogging software and not a CMS. But then in 2012 we started working on WordPress, and since then we've been pro WordPress people, and we've developed like 500 plus WordPress themes till today. But I don't code anymore, and I'm more into customer happiness management and project management. But I know coding to the extent that my developers cannot fool me. So that's about me. So coming to AMP, have any one of you heard about AMP before? AMP?
No.
Oh, no? So AMP stands for Accelerated Mobile Pages. Google announced it in October 2015 as a competitor to Facebook Instant Articles. So if you have ever been to Facebook and you open any article, you see that it comes up very quickly and the content loads very fast. So, and same is with Apple News. So Google came out with this concept of AMP, and initially it was focused only for publishers. But then Google gives, like, Google offers this now to the entire web to make it much faster. And so this Facebook and Apple, when news were just supported via the app, so you need to open the Apple News app, or you need to open the Facebook to view instant articles. And that's exactly where Google wanted to change from proprietary tools to open web, and that's how AMP came into picture. With Google AMP, Google like focuses on their ultimate aim is to load the page within 1 second. And how do they do that? Is one second looks very much like too promising, but how do they deliver it? Is Google caches each and every page that you have in their own cache. So when you go through Google, the website pages are not served from your server, but they are rather delivered from the Google cache server. And there are about 90 pages that are being cached every second on the Google AMP cache. So that's how Google just tries to deliver it to you within 1 second. So if you see this, if you have an AMP website, this is a small lightning bolt that comes over on Google that shows you that this particular website is built using AMP. And that's how the AMP, so all these new agencies that were using AMP, they kind of got the priority in the top carousel of Google. So that's the reason that people are kind of criticizing AMP a bit, because they think that it's too proprietary and Google is favoring AMP. And there was a misconception out there for a while that if your website is on Google AMP, it's going to be better on SEO and it's going to rank higher. But Google itself came up front and said that that's not the case. Your site, irrespective if it's loading in AMP or it's loading, but the only thing that Google wants to do is they want you to load your website quick, may it be AMP or may it without AMP. So that's a misconception so the reason I'm giving talk about AMP is because there are a lot of misconceptions about it. So if you see this, this website, this is our own website. And we just got AMP this year, and you can see that we got a small lightning bolt. So even if you see in the search engine rankings, Google says that it does not prioritize AMP pages, but it's kind of trying to show people that with this lightning bolt that this particular URL is AMP. So yeah, so if there are any developer clients and project managers, I think everyone needs to understand AMP very well, because these three people don't get along with each other. The project manager is kind of always trying to bring the developer and client on the same page. And each, like client these days are very smart, so they try to come up with their own notion of every technology. So this is just a slide that I dropped in. Another thing that you see these days is Google is trying to push AMP in certain way. So there is this website called ithinkwithgoogle.com, and if you go there and you see testmysite.ithinkwithgoogle.com, and you put in all your sites, so it checks your website on a 3G connection, and then once the site loads, and if it's not loading under 3 seconds, it gives you all the things that you need to do. And then it says try accelerated mobile pages. Now the funny thing is that this website that I am checking is already built on AMP, and it's still telling me to build using AMP. So Google is like, hey, use AMP. It's like, I'm not telling you, but if you use it, it's good for you. So here is how AMP finally achieves the 1 second load time. So if you are building websites and you're using CSS and JS and all those things, Google does, what normally happens is that all the JavaScript and everything is loaded right on the website. So Google uses asynchronous JavaScript, so it does not load your JavaScript before, it loads it after your DOM is loaded. Another thing is that they discourage usage of any third-party JS. So if you're using AMP, you cannot use jQuery or React.js or any other third-party JS library with AMP. If you do that, the Google is going to invalidate your AMP page. Another thing is that all the CSS that you write, you cannot link it. So normally if you write the CSS, we use the link attribute and we link the CSS. So that's not something you do in AMP. You use it under style space AMP custom, and you write all your CSS within that style AMP custom tag. And there is a restriction on the size, it needs to be under 50 KB. So now when you are using Google AMP, there are two versions, the desktop version and the AMP version. So this was how it was done initially. So your website page is going to have two different versions. That's the normal HTML, and then there is another version that is the AMP version of your page. And within the header tag, you have to write this thing called link relation AMP HTML. So what Google does is it goes to your page and finds out what the AMP version of your page, and it links down. So this is how you need to do canonical URL declaration. So if you want to validate your Google AMP page, you need to go to validator.ampproject.org, and you need to put your link over there. I'll just show it to you right now. So you go to validator.ampproject. So you can pass your So this is done. If we pass a normal website, let's say we pass WordPress.org, it says that there are these errors. Obviously, WordPress.org is not an AMP page. So this is a normal page. So you need to go to this URL validator and validate your URL. So once you have validated, you will have that lightning bolt symbol that I showed in the last slide. So these are the restrictions that you have. So you cannot use any third-party JS like AngularJS, jQuery. You cannot have all those fancy sliders, carousels, image filters, etc. that you have. So you cannot link any CSS, external CSS, and all the CSS that you write, it needs to be under 50 KB. Another thing that all the developers we do is we write important tag. You cannot have important in your CSS. You cannot embed iframe directly. Then, so you cannot use content form plugins like Content Form 7, Gravity Forms, and all those things. All these tags that we are used to writing, the IMG tag, video tag, iframe, you cannot just write it directly. Instead, you have to use its own HTML. That's called AMPING, AMP Video, AMP Iframe. And if you want to check out this website called ampproject.org. And there you can you go to reference components, and there you can see all the AMP HTML that you can use. So there is this. So one thing that you need to understand is that if you are using AMP, there is a whole new learning curve attached to it, because it's like you cannot use your normal HTML the way you have been using all these years. AMP has like a proprietary AMP tags for everything, like image, videos, iframes. So you need to go through this whole thing, and they have it pretty well documented. So you can just go through ampproject.org where you find all the detail.
I would say does make it really proprietary to Google.
Yeah, it does. So
that's why my boss will even entertain it.
Yeah, so this was our reaction when we first time listened to all those restrictions. We were like, no, we are not doing this. Yeah, but there are still certain misconceptions about AMP. People think that AMP is only for mobile web. Well, it's not the case, because if you see the ampproject.org website, it's built using AMP HTML. But of course, they will do it because they need to promote their technology. People think that with AMP you need to forget a better looking website. That's not the case, because if you see AMP's own website, it's beautiful. Then AMP restricts your layout and design capabilities. That's not the thing. You can design any kind of website that you want using AMP. Then people think that I cannot use AMP with my current website. That's not wrong. That's not true. And then people think that we'll have to, because AMP does not want you to use jQuery carousel sliders. So people think that your website cannot be interactive, but that's not the thing, because now these days you've got CSS sliders, CSS carousels, accordions, everything is in CSS. So we've been using jQuery, I don't know, for the wrong reasons. That is what when we started building AMP, we did think that you can do everything using CSS, because that's the power CSS has in itself. And then people think that you need to maintain two different websites. One is the AMP website and one is the non-AMP website. So that's not the thing. If you use native AMP, you can just use one website for both the non-AMP version. So with native AMP, there is no non-AMP version. It's just the AMP version of your website. That's the only thing that you have. So now, let's come to how do you amplify your WordPress website. Using plugins? Now, I won't do that. So, it's coding your own HTML using native AMP. So there are two plugins that exist right now. One is built by Automatic, XWP, and Google. That's called AMP for WordPress. And the other one that we have used, it's called AMP for WP. And both of these are pretty confusing, because the only thing that changes is WordPress and WP, nothing else. And to be honest, I didn't like the official one. I like the non-official version, because it's much easier to implement. And that's what we have implemented on our own website. So here are the pros of using AMP for WP. It's quick setup. If you just want to amplify your WordPress website, you can do it within minutes. Then so what this website does is it takes the video tags, the images tags, and it just converts all of them into AMPIMG, AMP video automatically. And it has a nice backend interface. It generates valid AMP HTML. And what it does is it removes all this JS that your theme has in it and all the unnecessary CSS. And if you have, if someone opens your particular blog page on mobile, it redirects automatically to the AMP version of that particular post. Cons is that it's good only if you use it for your blog, and right now it renders only the WP content in the free version. If you want to render ACF fields, you need to buy there another plugin. There is no free support for contact forms, and it has a very basic implementation. And for everything that you want to do, you have to buy add-ons, and the add-ons are like $90 to $100 per add-on. So it's pretty expensive. So these are the few cons of the thing. So here is, like, now I was talking about not using the plugin and taking the another route, that is native AMP. So how you can do that is, if you're a good HTML developer and you know CSS pretty well, you just need to, so because this is what was happening with my team, we were using a lot of imported tags and we were using a lot of repetitive CSS. So if you have heard about do not repeat yourself in try concepts, if you use all of that pretty well, you can build the entire HTML page under 50k CSS limit. And as like no third party JS for sliders, for carousels, you can use CSS page, and then you don't need to use any ing video tags and all those things. So these are the basic rules for native app. If you follow this, you don't need to have like two different versions. So yeah, so step one, prepare for the nightmare. If you as an HTML developer have exploited CSS by using imported tags, big class names, and repeated CSS. Step two you need to do is change your HTML to HTML space AMP. So that basically tells Google that this is the AMP page. And then what you do is you use this script from Google called cdn.ampproject.org/version0.js into the head. And yeah, just don't do this. We tried doing this. What we did is we just downloaded the whole JS and then we just uploaded it to our server. If you do that, Google is going to mark your page as invalid. Because what Google does is they have cached this whole v0.js in your browser through Chrome. So when you load your website, it does not have to do a round trip to print that JS file. So don't be smart and download this and upload it to your server. And then canonicalization. So now, initially, what we did is we had a relation tag that says relation is equals to AMP HTML, and it was pointing to another AMP URL. So now this particular relation is equals to AMP HTML points to itself, because the page itself is the AMP HTML page. Then, so if you want, so after that, so even if you want to use an AMP iframe, you need to include a JS for AMP iframe, and you can find all the list of HTML tags that the project supports. So here, if you want to use the AMP video, you have to have the AMP video. So these are the tags that AMP is supporting right now. So you can just go through this, and you can find the list of scripts that you need to include. So this is pretty contradicting, because Google tells you to not use scripts a lot, and that for everything that you do, Google asks you to add a new script. So this is pretty annoying, you know? So this is a case study on how we started doing building our first AMP WordPress website. Initially, when I told my team that we need to build the website using native AMP, my team did not believe. So it was like the whole team was divided, me versus the team saying me that we cannot build anything using native AMP. And I was like, no, if Google has did this, then even we can do it. So then my idea was to skip this two versions of the website and just build one version. So then that's the story. And when we started building the HTML the AMP way, so we used Bootstrap framework. So Bootstrap CSS itself is like 121 KB. So we were like, we are the base Bootstrap that we are using, that's like almost three times what AMP is allowing. So what we did is we stripped out Bootstrap, because when you use Bootstrap, it has got everything like the carousel and accordion stats and everything. So we removed all the CSS and we used only the column grids and all the CSS. So now that Google does not allow you to use any carousel and all those things like drop down menus and sliders, so we skipped from JS to CSS based sliders and carousel. And if you want to see the drop down menus, sliders, are also provided by AMP itself. So if you want to see all the components that AMP gives you, just go to this website called AMP by Example. And here are the carousels, all the components that Google gives you. So there's AMP accordion, then there is carousel. So if you see this, it's not that great, but it does the work for you. So you can have like tons of different components over here. There's this amazing thing called AMP Anim. So that does nothing but just pulls in the GIF. So they have a component for this. Can you believe this? Just to display and GIF. So the amazing thing that these guys have is something called as AMP Animation. It's under advanced. So this whole thing is just to show this small thing over here. They have a component. So everything that you want to do JS based, you have to go to AMP to say, okay, you have that? AMP will say, okay, here you go, take this. I have a component for that. And for every component that you use, there is a good amount of documentation. So it's a huge learning curve that you have to go. But
it's like a huge sacrifice in a lot of ways.
Yeah, it is like the whole life you were told that HTML is your mother. AMP comes to you. I'm your new mother.
We've been pushing for standards for so long, and now we're saying, oh, forget the standards.
That's what happened with relational database and NoSQL. Like, all the life we did was relational database. Mm-hmm. And then this MongoDB, Firebase, everyone came, and they said, we don't need relational database. We are moving back to file-based system. And so here is the thing. This is my own personal experience. It's not that I'm pro-AMP or something like that. But the moment my team built one AMP website, their HTML and CSS level, its standard has gone over here. Because all Google wants you to do is stop abusing the jQuery, the CSS, the HTML. Because that's if you open one WordPress theme out in Theme Forest, it's like, I don't know, how they even sell this thing?
Yeah, it's like a back to basics approach.
Yeah, I'll just show you one website that we've built. I would never use themes, but I used one theme for this website, and you can see the loading time sucks.
Yeah.
And I'll show you another website that we've built. It's not AMP, but it's something that my team built after using AMP, and you can see the speed that we've got. So I'm an Indian, so you see cricket everywhere.
Yeah, I will admit speed is a massive problem on our website. So.
Yeah, because we are using, so all major WordPress developers that I see, all they do is go to Theme Forest. Mm-hmm. Alright, give them this. Okay, then just change it and give it to the client. And the issue is that only because theme offers carousel, and the theme offers like 10 different things, and you are using just one out of it, but you are getting the load of almost every other thing.
Jackson Laboratory's primary website isn't even in WordPress, so. But I can still see redoing it. I don't know, redoing an app, I think it would give revolt from my boss.
Yeah, so here's the accordion. So these guys, so I've been to an AMP roadshow, and these guys are trying it hard to make it easier for people, because I understand that this is a whole new learning curve, but Google is never, so this was by Malte Ogul, who was the product manager for AMP, and he was specifically asked if Google is trying to enforce AMP. So he said that we are not doing it, we are just trying to standardize everything, but I think one thing that they failed in doing was having components for everything. Like, even having a component for image, for video, for iframe, that kind of sucks. And then, you cannot even have inline CSS. Like, you cannot have p space style is equals to, and put your style over there. You cannot do that in
there. I know, that's
what. Yeah, so if people are finding it very difficult to implement. So, that's what all of the story is about. So, yeah. So yeah, So then we stripped Bootstrap of all. So here you see, like, this is a good example. Like Bootstrap, we were using 121 KB. We got it down to somewhere about 16 kilobytes. Because there was all whole lot of unnecessary Bootstrap CSS that we were using. So we just stripped it off and we just used the amount of CSS that we needed from Bootstrap. So that's how it helped us. And then, as I say, you can go to AMP by example and you can see all the components that AMP offers. Now, we used Contact Form 7 for our forms on our website, but CF7 uses jQuery for validation and submitting the output to the database. So what we did is we dequeued all the JS file that Contact Form 7 was using. We just removed all of its JS file and we did code our own extension in AMP for Contact Form 7. And to do that, you just need to refer to this AMP form that tells you how to submit your form using AMP. So, and again, with this, you need a bit of knowledge of AngularJS because AMP is built using AngularJS. So it's all kind of proprietary Google, because AngularJS is Google, then AMP-HTML is using AngularJS. So we did like a bit of AngularJS available, so that helped us. So even after doing all of this, like stripping off the CSS and writing over CSS carefully, we were almost at 67 kilobytes, which was 17 kilobytes more than what Google has set the limit for. So the next thing that we did is we replace the class names. So we had like big class names like dot header or like top header, bottom header. We just removed them and we had dot a, dot b, dot c, dot a, b, dot c, q. We had just written on two names and we wrote down everything and that brought it down to 37 kilobytes.
That's unusable. That's not...
Well, I mean,
for only
you could,
machines.
That's not,
yeah, you could run it through like a Gulp pipeline.
Yeah.
And
we'll
just
read the right one.
Yeah, it just automated it.
So we didn't rewrite them. So we just wrote down a program in PHP that does it for us.
Okay.
And
it's like a compiler to minify
the
code.
Yeah, exactly.
My team would kill me if I asked them to rewrite all the class names. They would leave the job. They're like, we're not doing, we don't want to work. So finally, once the AMP-HTML was valid, all we had to do now is put it down in WordPress. And then there's the amazing thing called WYSIWYG Editor.
Yeah.
I think it's the biggest scam in the 21st century. Yeah, I don't think that WYSIWYG, what you see is what you get. We never get what we see. So that's what I think Gutenberg is for, but it's also in like, I don't know, I don't want to speak about it because there's been a lot of Gutenberg talks everywhere and there's a pen going down there. So now the issue with WordPress WYSIWYG Editor was that it gives you IMG, audio tag, video tag. So you're like, okay, so you cannot use that in AMP. You need to have AMP IMG, AMP audio, AMP video. So here comes PHP to the rescue and we use regex. We change all the IMG tag to AMP IMG, to AMP audio, AMP video. So there is a book called, I don't know the book because I'm not the developer who did this, but there is a book that is specifically for the WYSIWYG output that comes. So you can just hook out and before it compiles and gives back the HTML to the browser, you can change all the tags. So that said, AMP was validated. So now what we did is we cached all the HTML on our server using WP fastest cache. And here are the results. So this was the initial result. We were loading in around like 2 seconds or something. I need to check the results here. So it's like the load time is 1.063 seconds, but that's without caching. So then what we did is we cached the results and then with caching we got it down to 1.16. Wow.
Yeah.
So we finally came somewhere close to 1 second load time, which Google wants to. So Google is very happy with us that we are using that
technology. Yes, please, the Google.
Yes, so I'm going to Google like we did.
And what was the one? What was the timing on the one before AMP?
No, we never did the website in AMP. Like without AMP, it was like built from scratch.
We should have done it before.
Yeah, maybe we should have.
Have to.
So now our team is thinking to come up with our own AMP suit. So I know that none of you is convinced that you use AMP. But still, I'll tell you what we are thinking to do is, number one thing that we are doing is the cache plugin. It's called Carousel Accordion Tabs and Sliders that helps you build your own Carousel Accordion Tabs using AMP. Then we already have the beta version of the contact form 7 for AMP. So what it does, it just removes all the CSS and JS from contact form 7 and it replaces our JS and everything. So we are coming up with compatibility for Ninja, Gravity, Caldera and Jetpack forms. So then the opt-in forms is like, you can create an opt-in form for subscription that connects to MailChimp, Constant Contact and 20 other providers. And then there's something called a spirit button. Which kind of sounds stupid, because all it does is you click on it and it just counts the favorite. Then there is social sharing button, and yeah, for scroll to top, AMP has its own component. And then there is something called as AMP reactions, so you can have Facebook-like reactions on your blog post. So we are thinking to have this somewhere in the mid of 2019, because to work with them, it's a lot of things to do. And there's an AMP editor that we already have, so if someone wants this, we can give you the copy of the plugin. And what it does basically, it just replaces all the tags, the ing tag with AMP ing. And so here's another interesting thing that AMP did with video. So if you search for AMP YouTube, so there is a component called AMP-YouTube. So what you do there is nothing, you just give him the data video ID from YouTube and it renders the AMP and the YouTube video for you in the AMP webs. So what all we did initially was we went to YouTube, clicked on the embed button, then took the iframe embed code and then put it out over here on your website.
Yeah.
All of that is gone. All you need to do is use AMP YouTube. But again, to use AMP YouTube, you need to have the AMP YouTube JS for that. So yeah, that is something that we are still working on. We thought that we would launch it within 2 months. Yeah, so the another amazing thing that Google has come up with is something called as AMP Stories. So just like you have stories for Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, it's all proprietary to the app that you're using. So now Google has brought it out in the open web. So now you can have your own stories on the web. So this is one story that people.com did on Prince Harry and their whole wedding, the A to Z thing. So this is a video of how Google wants to use AMP. So there was this Stanley Cup that was going on. So if you search on Google, there is this story, and all the stories come with this kind of icon, and you click this, and these are the kind of stories that render. So this is something really amazing that Google is coming up with, and this is going to be a new SEO thing that is going to hit the market soon.
So do you know when that's going to happen?
That was the exact question that I had for the AMP team and the AMP roadshow. So here's the thing, why it's not happening right now, is because it's like, if you know, there's this job experience circle that keeps on going. You don't have a job because you don't have an experience, you don't have an experience because you don't have a job. So that's why Google is stuck up right now. So they don't have enough content to crowd, so they cannot show the stories, and they cannot show the stories because. So it's like that. So the more content people will create, the more pages, stories Google will have to crawl, mm-hmm. and the more they crawl, they come up with more results. And so they have already started doing that with few news companies. I'll just open it up in my simulator. So if you search for Washington Post, you can see something called as visual stories from WashingtonPost.com. Mm-hmm. So there are the stories that are happening. So you click on this, and the AMP story comes up. Mm-hmm. Like this.
So it really is more for content providers and less for like product demos.
No, I don't agree with you on that. Because we are, so that's another thing that I want to talk about. Is that the moment we saw about AMP stories, our team started working on a product where you can build AMP stories just by drag and dropping. I don't want to do it here because it's kind of a commercial product and WordPress is more of an open source. So it's kind of contradicting, but if you want, I can show it to you in person. But if you suggest, you just think of a restaurant, it changes its special menus every day. So what they can do is they can have this whole stories created on their website, and they can have a very small link, a bit.ly link, and they can have it like today's menu, just scan the QR code, and the specials menu comes up straight away, they tap through the menu. So these are the, so another good usage of this is, if you heard of Blue Apron, so Blue Apron, it has, it deals with the whole kit to prepare the food. So you just have the QR code on your kit, you just scan it, and it just gives you the steps, you can just tap, and you get the whole recipe on your phone. So there are some real good, but it's more of for affiliate marketing. Because now what Google has did is, you can include ads within your AMP store. Mm-hmm. So I think Washington Post did that. I don't know if it's on this story. It's not on this story, but Washington Post has a story where they... But AMP Stories does have monetization capabilities inside it. So you can put your ads within AMP Stories. Yep.
Are the AMP tags cross-browser compatible? If this is a Google thing, why is Safari and, you know, IE and all
that? So what... So if you know something about JS these days, there's something called a shadow dome. So that sits above the dome. So with HTML5, you can create your own HTML tags. So what Google is actually doing is it's creating its own tag. So if you see, so this is a website that we built, and it's super, super quick. So if you see this image, I'll just do an inspect element on this. So here is the AMP ING tag. So what Google is actually doing is inside the AMP HTML, AMP ING tag, I'll just zoom this for you. So it is putting up an ING tag inside. So this is how Google is built. And you can see all the stupid classes names, Y, ZP, JL, SA, HB. So this is how we just and all your CSS needs to go inside this, the style tag called... So you see, that's like, Google is telling us don't use it?
Yeah, so it seems a lot like a login. Like,
yeah.
Whereas you're like loading, I mean, because theoretically, right, you're just loading in the JS files that you need at page load.
Yeah, but here's the thing, Google is smart.
Yeah.
They know that people are going to use my browser.
Yeah.
So if you see that, each and every extension that Google is using, they already have it cached on the browser.
Okay.
Yeah, so you don't have to do that round trip all the way to Google server to bring on that JS file. So this is how, this is the style AMP custom.
Yeah.
Here is all your CSS goes, so you can see this. So here we had another issue. We named a class called A, and there is an A tag. So there was an issue that we came. So then we, while we were doing a regex replacement, we said that PHP 5 don't use this class name. So here is all the SOR you can see.
On the base, like bootstrap itself.
So here it is, like o.o/um/li. And then you also need to minify this. So if you are using something like SAS, where you can kind of monitor all these things, so it really becomes helpful in those times. So you can see .ux/h3. So these are the small class names that we use. So when we build, if I can, I'll just walk you through the backend that we have. So our original CSS is not the one that you are seeing here. It's completely different. If I can, so this is our CSS over here, and it does not have anything like. So these are the class names that we actually have. Mm-hmm. It's like .img overlay, .feature image section. So what the PHP code does is it takes the standard CSS, it does the regex, and then it gives back to the style. So it gives back to this tag over here. So this style tag that you are seeing, this one, it's being generated on runtime. And then we cache this.
That makes sense.
So it's too much of work.
Yeah.
Just
to load
in 1 second. So that's.
I don't know.
That's
what
I'm asking.
Of,
that's what I wanted to know. Do you feel like it's worth it? That was a lot.
Well, when Google decides it's a ranking factor.
So here's the thing. If you're not motivated to do something, Google comes. Google tells you only one magical word. I'll rank you.
Exactly.
And people just run behind it. Like anything.
So I have a question though. I thought, you know, when I first heard about this, it was all about mobile. So what happened? Like, why was I hearing that it was?
Well, that's technically what it was originally for.
That's what the name of it is.
Yeah, because if you search on Google or something, I search for Donald Trump, and you can see that you have all this AMP things going on. You see CNN is on AMP, NBC is on AMP, because initially it was not for the general public. Initially, it was only for publishers, and Google worked exclusively with publishers for like 2 years, and then it came to the general public. It is an open source project. You can contribute just like you can contribute to WordPress. You can contribute to AMP HTML. Yes.
Hi. Sorry, we're gonna have to wrap it up here.
Yeah.
The last
session. Sure. if anyone has other questions, yeah.
If a project built like one page, let's say four pages will be AMP. And another page, so the reason it will be just normal HTML or WordPress, will be any conflict?
No, it's just that the other page won't have this lightning bolt icon if someone searches it on Google. So if you see this, when you click on this URL, you see the speed that it's loading with?
Yes.
It's because Google basically caches your entire page. So this thing is actually not being served from CNN website, it's actually being served from the Google's cache. So that's, and Google has got servers across the globe. So what it does, it takes, so basically it takes away your pain of using a CDN, and it mounts it on Google's own CDN. So people from anywhere around the world, it just finds the person closer to its server, and it serves from that server. So it's in fact it's a good thing. You just need to have that kind of obsession for speed.
Yeah.
You need to be stupid enough to build such
websites. But well, it pushes you to like work within restrictions because it's so easy to get like.
Yeah, it's actually good. If you see the speed of this website, it's